Hai guys, balik lagi di For the Love of the Game dan gue Chris. Kali ini kita akan melalui small review gue terhadap game Deadline. Oke, game Deadline secara singkat adalah game mengenai detective just trying to solve the case. Jadi kooperatif game di mana semua pemain menjadi detektif dan terdapat 12 kasus yang bisa kita mainkan, mulai dari ada different level, jadi easy, normal, and hard. Dan small review ini berdasarkan one play dari kasus pertama ya, dengan level easy, so make it easy for me. Dan gue udah ada menjelaskan how to play the game. Mungkin bisa cek di situ bagaimana cara mainnya. Gue nggak akan cover all the details of the rules, but basically di game ini kita akan saling bantu-membantu untuk memecahkan kasus dengan menjawab pertanyaan. Oke? Okay? Nah, pertanyaan mengenai siapa ya pelakunya dan motifnya apa, senjata pembunuhnya apa dan lainnya. Oke, okay. Jadi ada different kind of books in here. Pertama kita akan baca case book, di mana kemudian setelah permainan berakhir kita akan baca case questions dan kemudian cek apakah jawaban kita benar di solution book. Oke, okay. Nah, gamenya sedikit unik. Sebenarnya hanya hand management dan chaining cards. Dari yang sudah kalian ketahui di How to Play, if you already see it. Jadi simbol-simbol ini yang kita connect untuk memecahkan atau complete the clue cards ya, yang ada di bawah sini. Jadi pada dasarnya clue cards-nya ada banyak dalam satu case dan masing-masing memberikan informasi penting di belakangnya. Tiap orang juga punya special ability, setiap detektif, a powerful one, and can be played once for the rest of the game. Jadi sebenarnya mainkan kartu untuk mendapatkan connect symbolnya tersebut itu it's just a mini game, okay? It's not related to the case. Jadi yang penting adalah setelah kita complete clue cardnya, kita akan balik dan baca informasi yang bisa kita dapatkan dari situ. Dan sometimes it can lead you to another clue case. Jadi berdasarkan informasi yang lo dapat di clue case tersebut, ternyata itu mengarahkan kalian ke clue case lainnya. Yang jadi kalian bisa milih, oh kita harus ke sana, atau mungkin just do a random choice of the clue card. It doesn't matter because in the end kalian juga harus menyelesaikan semuanya ini. It matters ketika kita nggak bisa selesaiin semuanya dan harus menyelesaikan investigation karena tiga kali gagal ya. Oke, okay. Itu matters karena you will lose out a lot of information dari clue case yang belum kita clue card dari yang belum pernah kita selesaikan. Oke. Okay. Nah, for me it's a unique game. It's very simple. It's a tea time game, I suppose, that you can sit with your friends, take a simple chat, very light mood, okay, and then play this one. It doesn't really have to be a very thinky game. There is no very long downtime on it, and the game has a unique feel for a mystery solving game. So if you like that kind of game, a detective game, problem solving, no, it's not problem solving, mystery detective, that kind of theme, it's pretty much interesting because all the cases you will discuss with your friends. Yeah, who is the bad guy, what his motive, the killer weapon, something like that, the alibi checkouts or not. Jadi it's very interesting But the problem is, yes, the art for the first, not everyone like it. I feel it neutral again with towards it. So still a good looking art for me. The cards bad. I don't like this kind of black and white newspaper thingy, old photograph thingy. So that's can't complain, right? The detective character is good. Okay. The other, this one, good. Very simple, very clear. Then the replayability. Okay, that's the problem in this game. Okay. Basically, there are 12 cases, and you can play 12 times, or maybe 12 successes. So if you already succeed, I don't think you will play again, because you already know the answer, the questions and the answers. So it's not good. So if I already finished case one, I will not playing it again, because I didn't know the answer. That's the problem with this game. So if I have played all the cases, complete all the cases, I think it's no longer playable. Seem like what? Pandemic Legacy or something? Legacy games? Like Time Stories? I don't know. I played Time Story once and I get that feeling. So that's how it is. It's like that. So that's my small review, and I hope you like it and give you a bit of information and how the game it is, not how the game played, but how the game it is. Okay, see you in another next video.